Kenya Medical Training College, the Department of Clinical Medicine. I'm going to present to you, this is a study that was done in Kakamega County Hospital, factors influencing utilization of clinical teaching among clinical teachers in Kakamega County Hospital, Kakamega, that is Kenya. In introduction, you can say that bedside teaching is a specialized form of clinical teaching involving a small group of learners that takes place in the presence of the patient. And actually, it's the most patient-centered of all teaching venues. To add on, we know that clinical practice remains the most critical part of health education, and it gives an opportunity to combine cognitive, psychomotor, and effective clinical skills among learners. Through bedside teaching or clinical teaching, the learners are able to acquire the skills of observation, communication, examination, and professionalism. Just like our father of medicine, that is, we know our father of medicine who commented and said that actually there should be no teaching where we don't have the patient. The students will understand better what they are learning when they interact with the patient and when they are taught where the patient is. They are able to get more information, they are able to gain more skills. When they have the patient, they are able to see the patient. And so this study aimed at determining factors that influence utilization of bedside teaching among the clinical teachers in this Kakamega County Hospital, with the specific objectives of determining the demographic distribution of the clinical teachers in relation to the bedside teaching, the level of utilization of bedside teaching in this county hospital, and also to be able to determine the reasons for utilization of bedside teaching. The methodology, this was a descriptive cross-sectional study. We had a population size of 80 clinical teachers who were sampled through convenience sampling method, and data collection was through self-administered questionnaires, and the analysis was by itself. So the findings of the study, the level of bedside teaching in this county hospital stands at about 65%, although the majority of the respondents, that is 80%, reported having no formal training in bedside teaching. Another thing that was found from this study is that there was lack of setting of objectives before bedside session, which was evidenced by 85% of the respondents. We know that in any kind of teaching, actually if the objectives are not set before the session, then it means that the kind of teaching that is going to take place, it may not be effective. And another finding was that majority of the respondents, the clinical teachers were above 40 years, comprising of 35%, while 31 to 35 years we had 23.7%, then between 36 and 40 years we had 21.3%, and below 30 years we had 20%. It also showed that most respondents, that is 50%, reported appreciation of the patient's appreciation when involved in bedside teaching session, while 30%, that is 24 of them, reported patient unwillingness. And now we have researchers that have documented that patients will actually not prefer having a bedside session around them. But when these clinical teachers were asked, 50% reported that actually patients appreciate when bedside teaching is done around them, because at the end of it all, they end up even understanding their condition. And this will only happen if the patient has been informed prior, not just being ambushed. Because, you know, in clinical or in bedside teaching, it has an approach whereby the clinical teacher has to prepare even the patient to know that actually we are going to have a session with the students around here and we are going to learn some issues with them. But I don't know whether that is the practice that is going on. Maybe the patients are unwilling because we go on ambushing them when we want to teach our students. The patients just realize, oh, we have a group of students, around 15 students, surrounding the patient plus their teacher, and they are talking about the patient when he or she is not even aware. So in conclusion, we say that bedside teaching is actually utilized by clinical teachers in Kakamega County Hospital at 65%, although the majority of clinical teachers, accounting for 80%, have no formal training, or they have no training in bedside or in clinical teaching. So the recommendation was that clinical teaching should be incorporated in curriculum for all health workers at basic training, and also during their continuous professional development. And when it is incorporated in their curriculum, as they qualify and they start working, they'll be able to handle the students that come in their hands for them to teach. And even during their continuous professional development, they'll be able, as they get more information or as they get new knowledge on how to conduct clinical teaching or bedside teaching, we shall end up having health professionals that are competent. And we know that the health care that will be provided to the patients will be complete and will be comprehensive. And to that, I say thank you. Asante sana.